Okay. Libet is a neurologist. The Libet, he put a probes to the brain and did some experiment called Libet's experiment. It's called famous Libet's experiment. Okay. Where Libet's experiment, any action which you do, okay, 200 milliseconds before that action, that is 0.2 seconds before that action, the body has already decided. Okay. For example, I want to eat this banana. Okay. So this is the thought. Before the thought came, 200 milliseconds before, the body has started acting. That means the decision is not taken by conscious mind, decision is taken by the body, which is subconscious mind. So that's what it means. So, but you have a 200 millisecond gap. In that 200 millisecond gap, you can decide to veto, stop that action.
But again, to stop it also, you have to move it back. But then they already...
No, no, you may withdraw your hand, something like that.
But then there again, the body would have thought of it.
Body may think of doing, but not doing something may not be in the purview of the body. I don't know. Okay. So, but in general, any action, any conscious decision, okay, will happen only about 200 milliseconds after the body has started acting. The body starts acting first, right? So that means you are behaving like a programmed machine. The thought, after the thought comes that, oh, I want to eat banana, I want to do this. So the conscious thought is, there's a gap between the conscious thought and action happening. This is what is Libet's experiment says, which has implication that you don't have a free will, conscious free will. Right? So that is the implication of that. Now, that is for action. But we are speaking of thoughts of the past and future. What you are bugged is, most of your life you are suffering is not the action, the constant past and future coming and interfering in the mind. Right? Constantly, oh, what's happening to me? Oh, something is happening to me. Okay, why should I take care of this? Why should I not do this? That constantly the thoughts, past and future thoughts are bombarding. So this past and future thoughts, which you are bombarding our mind, is what we call as mind. Right? So then action, the thought which arises after action is also a thought, but what is bothering us is the constant churning of the thoughts of the past and future coming and affecting our present moment. And none of these four thoughts are real. They are unreal thoughts. We keep on worrying, what will happen to this thing? What will happen to this? What will happen? These are all thoughts which arise. So as you become more evolved, as you become more conscious, these thoughts will come down drastically. Because the center called I has changed.
So, let's say there is an event in the future which I'm supposed to do. But at this moment, do I take a decision about that event, should I do it or not? Or just leave it, because anyway if it's going to happen.
No. See, it is like this. Something has to be done, something has to happen in tomorrow or day after tomorrow. Okay. What you can do today, you can plan about it. You can do the planning. Okay. The planning is always in the present moment. But worrying about the event is the future. Okay? When you plan, you are in the present moment. In reality, when you are doing some work or doing even planning, there are unnecessary thoughts are not there, zero. You are completely involved in that. The thoughts will come only when your mind drifts from that present moment. So something has to be done in the future. Do very well, plan it. Get fully involved in the plan. Okay? And while getting involved in the plan, don't worry about the future. What will happen? What will not happen? Don't worry about the past. Come to the present moment. Do the best planning in the present moment. Tomorrow, when that occasion comes, execute the plan also. When you don't have a plan, you don't have a problem when you are executing, when you are doing. you have problem only worrying about the past or future. That worrying about the past or future you have to address, not planning. The planning you have to do. Action you have to do. Right? Even though the action appears to be not free will, okay? You have apparent free will. You feel you are free to do. In that apparent free will, you live your, do your, you live, live. Okay? So, no need to stop planning. Planning you have to do. And whatever action required for tomorrow, you have to do today, do it. For example, tomorrow you may have to cook some food. You have to bring the vegetable, bring it. Or tomorrow say, tomorrow I'll make rotis. Okay? So plan it. Nothing wrong in that. The problem is not thinking, not the planning. The problem is worries about the plan. The problem is what will happen if it doesn't work. That is what you have to reduce. Adnani, in the case of Adnani, these thoughts of past and future will be less. They'll come. They may come also. But he will not be very much affected by them. Okay. He knows how to ignore them.
Thoughtlessness, thoughtless samadhi state is only bliss, Guruji. So how is that irrelevant for Ajnani?